Formation of a system of accounting for geopathogenic zones for solving problems of urban planning in the aspect of sustainable development of Russian cities. Introduction. The main goals and objectives of the strategy are as follows. To create a comfortable urban environment in the majority of Russian regions and develop cities within the established boundaries by means of comprehensive improvement of industrial zones and reconstruction of built-up areas. To shift from the city expansion to an effective use of built-up areas and vacant sites within the city boundaries. The relevance of the study is determined by the fact that the issues of healthy lifestyle promotion through a harmonious development of cities in natural environment have got vital social importance. To solve this problem, it is necessary to develop a methodology for geopathogenic zone detection and mapping to be considered in site plans and general layouts of settlements. It is also imperative to introduce new restrictions into the norms that regulate the development of residential complexes in such zones. The purpose of this work is to focus on the factor that on one hand is a cause of negative effects in human health and on the other hand a reason for development a methodology of conduction surveys of the sites that are located within existing city boundaries and elaborating the regulatory framework for residential areas design and construction. Materials and methods. The materials for the analysis are scientific papers that investigate the effects revealed in recorded health problems and deviation from normal physical and mental conditions. The obtained information is analyzed and generalized. Results and discussion. The theory and practice of urban planning takes into account natural factors of the environment. In view of this, the urban planning science has developed special planning techniques and urban planning solution. The problem of environmental impact on human health is also one of the most important ones in environmental medicine. Long-time exposure to negative environmental factors can have a serious impact on a human life history by causing functional disorders that may lead to various diseases in the future. So far comprehensive human health risk assessment systems that take into account combined effects of physical and chemical factors have been developed and implemented in urban planning in order to minimize the impact of harmful factors. All-inclusive assessments help to identify the most problematic city areas. Their results are used in mapping urban pollution zones and they are taken into account in urban planning. The present research reflects an attempt to apply an integrated approach to the optimization of city structures, forecasting the development of current environmental conditions and elaborating the design proposals that can incorporate reconstruction measures for environmentally neglected urban areas by utilizing urban ecology principles. Geopathogenic zones of urban areas as an underestimated risk factor. As increased permeability and stress zones represented by faults and as a rule guided by underground water flows or polar canals of ancient rivers, geological heterogeneities in the structure of the earth crust make the zones of biological discomfort. Such anomalies belong to geopathogenic zones. They can be one of the factors that can have a negative impact on human health. A geopathogenic zone is a generalized concept that refers to the earth surface areas of various size wherein there is a set of distinct geophysical, geochemical and energy phenomena that can produce aggregate effects. These phenomena can be recorded and studied by means of modern instruments. The role of geopathogenic zones in the development of various diseases and human health disorders is studied and discussed in numerous scientific papers that have been published by Russian physicians, biologists, physiologists, in collaboration with geologists and geophysicists in recent decades. Such integrated approach is determined primarily by practical need to protect people from the risk of cancer, cardiovascular and other diseases, as well as from physiological and mental disorders. The majority of experts believe these negative effects of geopathogenic zones are the most important challenges to be met. When discussing the phenomenon of geopathogenic zones, we should focus on physiological changes occurring in human organisms. Examination of the patients who have lived in geopathogenic zones for a long time reveals significant deviations from normal parameters. Patients with mental disorders, brain tumors, stomach, lung and ovar cancers are more likely to be the residents of the areas that coincide with GPZs. These materials allow us to say that some external physical influences can cause a restructuring of physiological processes in human bodies. Because of their main manifestation, they can be classified as a complex of non-specific changes inherent in the general adaptation syndrome that is materialized primarily by means of central nervous and endocrine systems. Available medical information demonstrates that the presence of geopathogenic factor contributes to the development of many diseases, including cancer, multiple sclerosis, arthritis, and cardiovascular diseases, or makes the treatment inefficient. Inside buildings, geopathogenic zones may be manifested by some secondary indicators. Among them are deformation and destruction of walls, the wetting with apparent mold, rust and moss, partial or complete yield of the building foundation, local damage of roads and underground communication, systematic abnormalities in physical process and chemical reactions. There are registered data that harmful industrial emissions in the atmosphere can accumulate within the boundaries of such zones and that is not related with the intensity of production process in the area. Spatial organization of urban areas based on the mapping of geopathogenic zones. It is generally known that construction in the area of landfills or industry-related sites is indemisable. However, the impact of geopathogenic zones is usually not taken into account. In this case, serious problems may arise and the solution may demand a lot of money, effort and time in the future. It is necessary to take into account geopathogenic factors in construction and include energoinformational studies into engineering surveys with mandatory mapping of health pathogenic zones. Currently, it is possible to use various methods to study geopathogenic zones and perform the zoning of future settlement territories considering the level of GPZ influence. Therefore, obviously, it is necessary to change approaches to territorial planning and urban planning regulation and conduct comprehensive site surveys with exploration of geopathogenic zones before construction begins. The magnitudes of geopathogenic zone impacts on biological systems should be reflected in medical biological maps in full compliance with relevant regulations and the outcomes of practical surveys. Where the cities for the construction of residential, educational and healthcare buildings should be designed very clearly. In the vicinity of geopathogenic zone, it is admissible to locate limitedly attended facilities such as exhibition centers or service supplying companies. Within the zones themselves, it is possible to make green spaces, install power lines or run secondary roads. The spatial position of a GPZ within the boundaries of exciting development areas should be taken into account take a decision about changing an educational, children care and medical institution into an organization with a less vulnerable form of activity. Such measures can be successful only provided that a specialized municipal service is organized to identify map a register geopathogenic zones in urban development areas. The very first thing such function should do at the initial stage of a project is to survey the site for the presence of geopathogenic zones. Surveying can give a complete distribution picture of energoinformational structures within the site intended for construction or renovation. Such work should include collection and analysis of available topographic, geodesic, and historical materials for the construction area, conduction field surveys, determination of a GPZ, and preparation of the technical report. There are various tools and survey methods that can be used to identify a GPZ. Engineering and survey materials, historical data, information about natural and environmental conditions of an area, a site or a project can be obtained from regional or local architecture and urban planning authorities, design and survey institutes, federal, regional and local archives, environmental centers and other organizations. If there is a need in additional data on natural conditions, a reconnaissance survey of area, site of location can be carried out. During a long period of GPZ studies, researchers have tried a variety of methods, instruments and devices to detect anomalous zones and measure their fields and radiation emissions. However, it is difficult to design a universal instrument for such purpose, because in a GPZ there can be many kinds of electromagnetic fields and radiation emissions that have different amplitude, frequency characteristics, intensity, polarization and modulation. All currently known devices and methods of GPZ detection can be divided into three main groups: determination of GPZ boundaries, measurement of geophysical characteristics in the supposed GPZ location, assessment of the functional state of a person who is staying in the supposed active zone. The cost of the prospective construction site examination can be included into the cost of engineering and construction surveys performed of the customer's expense. With minor rise in the site exploration cost will be paid back in the future, as the maps of natural GPZs never become outdated and just can be supplemented and extended. If a new man-made zone appears, for example, due to a heavy metal pollution of electromagnetic field effects, therefore, a municipality can use once-made GPZ plans for many years. Conclusions. Geopathogenic factors call for a reinterpretation of the role of urban science and architecture in the future of mankind. In the current city construction situation, these factors will keep showing themselves, considering a strong tendency towards high-density urban development. Certainly, in a continuously growing city, the development has to pass relatively large, unsuitable land plots, leaving them unaffected in the city system. Such lands may present a development challenges that can be met by the cataloging of lands in order to identify the areas with adverse environmental conditions and work out mitigation programs. The theory and practice of studying geopathogenic zones should pay specific attention to the energy informational fields of burial sites. The importance of this problem is determined by the fact that in modern towns and cities, these places can be numerous and located so haphazardly that they break into residential area structures as a part of neighborhood. There they may become a place for road construction or location of a construction project. A model of urban planning safety should be made in the form of territorial map, where all ecologically unsafe zones are marked with clear identification of relevant urban planning measures specified for each zone. This information can be used to design projects of urban development or reconstruction of urbanized areas with a purpose to improve environmental situation and public health. The development of an urban safety model should incorporate the most efficient regional, organizational, technical and preventive programs that can provide for the monitoring, assessment and forecasting of environmental conditions and public health, as well as for the actions aimed at detection, prevention and elimination of harmful factors affecting people's life and health. Thanks for your attention.